Hello, welcome to another Purple Insider Extra. Matthew Collar here, along with Sam Ekstrom. And a reminder to go listen to our longer conversations wherever you get your podcast. Just type in Purple Insider and you will find us. Also, purpleinsider.substack.com. You can see our written work there. All right, Sam, we are marching toward training camp. Let's talk about some of the biggest storylines of camp. And I want to begin with what's at the top of my list, and that is wide receiver three. Who will be behind Adam Thielen and Justin Jefferson throughout this offseason? We thought that the Minnesota Vikings would make a concerted effort to not have Chad Beebe and BC Johnson battling that out. But instead, here we are just before training camp, and those two guys appear to be the favorites.
Yeah, the Vikings looked at the situation and they said, this is fine. We'll just get Chad Beebe back on a $920,000 deal. We'll draft Amir Smith-Marset in the fifth round, and this will be great. We'll have a big old competition. Now, I don't get as freaked out about this as maybe some people do, because when you look at Chad Beebe's role last year, we're talking about 20 snaps a game, which is not major. Now, was he super effective in those 20 snaps? No, they can do better. But it is only 20 snaps a game. This is not a four wide receiver offense. I think where your concern lies is if someone gets hurt for a long period of time, do you want to have another BC Johnson for a long period in the season, or Chad Beebe? People, I think, might have oversold how well BC Johnson did 2 years ago. It wasn't phenomenal. I mean, he didn't get deep. He only had more than two catches once in like the eight games after Adam Thielen got hurt. So I think they can do much, much better. The problem is, they haven't really equipped themselves with a lot of resources. I think there's only two players that could maybe beat out BB or BC. Number one, KJ Osborne. Had a really good OTAs, former fifth-round pick. Didn't get a chance last year. You can blame that probably on the lack of preseason, the lack of offseason, but he looks a lot better. I think he could make a push. And then the rookie, Amir Smith-Marset. We haven't seen much out of him yet. Sometimes it takes a while for rookies. Maybe he has a good preseason and makes the leap. But if they signed any like veteran off the street, that might end up being a better option than what they have. It is not an embarrassment of riches.
Why do you think that the Vikings did not sign anyone for this position? Usually in past years, what we've seen is they bring in a Tajay Sharp. They bring in a Kendall Wright. Now, not that either one of those guys worked out for them very well, but usually they take a shot on some cheap free agent to come in and try to be wide receiver three. Even Josh Doctson was here for a very brief moment, and this year they haven't done that. I read that one of two ways. Either they looked at it and said, you know, this just has not worked with bringing in kind of randoms from the bottom of the barrel, or they think Larry Fitzgerald will become a Viking. Which option is more likely?
I think it's the former. I think they looked at it and said they were okay. And here's the other thing. If you're a veteran, if you are Larry Fitzgerald, and you look at the way the Vikings use the third wide receiver position, do you really want to be that person who is sort of on the outskirts of the offense, only gets in when it's third and 12? I could see why veterans wouldn't want to come here. And maybe the Vikings are holding out. They have kind of played the long game at some of these positions and waited to bolster through free agency. But it feels like they're just standing pat at wide receiver. I think they've convinced themselves that Chad Beebe is perfect in his niche, which is third and short. He can run a short route and get separation. I think they've convinced themselves that BC Johnson, who was at one time the wide receiver two on this team, is still a pretty good player. They don't need a ton of wide receivers in this offense. They only need one person to emerge. So out of the like seven or eight young receivers that will be competing for this job, they hope that there will be one that stands above the rest and surprises some people.
Or you're right that they could just be happy with what they have with Chad Beebe. They've really leaned into Chad Beebe over the last few years. They stuck with him through injuries, and then he and BC Johnson did have a good game when they filled in for Adam Thielen. So maybe that could be, even though a very small sample and against Carolina, enough to say, oh, okay, well, they can handle it in a small stint. And at this point in the game with free agency, who else is going to be able to handle that role anyway? I mean, nobody that you were bringing in free agency would just be able to fill in for Justin Jefferson. So I guess you could make that argument. Also, they were looking like they were a team on the brink with the cap for most of the offseason, and then suddenly they have cap space here as we go into training camp. So maybe that changes something with some of the remaining free agents. Last question for you. When do you think we'll know if one of the guys who is supposed to emerge will emerge? And I'm thinking of a couple of years ago when they drafted BC Johnson and they drafted Dylan Mitchell, and we didn't really have a sense until the last couple of weeks of training camp. But this year we do have preseason games. So I want to know when you think this will be decided who is wide receiver three.
Yeah, so I'm thinking back to the last two kind of obscure receivers to emerge, which are BB and BC. BC Johnson was going nowhere, like going into August. He was part of a young receiver group that had been criticized by Mike Zimmer. He was dropping balls. And then it was like preseason games 3 and 4 where he made some plays. I think he had a touchdown, looked better in practice, and earned that spot on the team. Chad Beebe was likewise a very late bloomer in his rookie year. And I think he might have even made the team if it were not for a late injury in preseason, which I think kind of sent him to, you know, recovering and ending up on the practice squad that year where he was later activated. So latter half of preseason, we're talking maybe August 15th through 18th through 21st, like kind of the dog days, right? Where we think we know what we're seeing and then somebody sneaks up on you. I think only three preseason games this year, we might not know until that third one against Kansas City.
We'll be keeping our eye on the battle for wide receiver three all throughout training camp. So make sure you follow us again on the podcast for these longer conversations, Purple Insider and purpleinsider.substack.com. And we'll also catch you here. So make sure you subscribe here as well. We'll see you later.